Hello everyone, this is Kanfer here. Today another demonstration video how to set up and running a Panorama Spectrum Analyzer under Windows 10. So Panorama Spectrum Analyzer, it's a graphical user interface for RTL power. So what's RTL power? From OsmoCom source, you can see when you installing the OsmoCom source, you can see the RTL power. This is here. You use differently RTL TCP and RTL ADSB and all these RTL FM. So what's RTL power? So RTL power is a command line tool for logging wideband frequency, power scans to CSV files. And the CSV files can then be used for analysis or to create a large frequency plot images. And this tool is available as a part of official OsmoCom rtlsdr drivers, as you can see from here. Okay, rather than using RTL power via command line under Linux based, this is a Windows 10 based GUI for RTL power calling RTL pan. So it's rtlsdr panorama. So after installing it from the links description in a video, don't forget to subscribe my channel and hit the bell icon and to be strengthened for another future contact. Okay, after downloading the RTL pan from links in description, you need to download the OsmoCom libraries. I will put in the link description to download the OsmoCom libraries from link description. After that, you need to put 6 files from OsmoCom libraries to Windows build. Okay, here the files. We need to copy the libgcc DLL file and the librtlsdr.dll file and the libusb one and the libwin this DLL5, and we need to copy the RTL power. So let's copy all these 5 files right now and paste it here in this folder with the RTL pan that you downloaded, and unzip this here in this folder. So we need another DLL, it's calling rtlsdr.dll. So you can bring it from your SDR sharp program if you install it in your PC. So let's bring the rtlsdr.dll. So let's copy the rtlsdr.dll from here and paste it here. Okay. Now you have a 6 dependencies files with RTL pan. Okay, now let's running the RTL pan by double click on it. Okay, let's put it to start from 88 megahertz to 108 and let's hitting start. Okay, let's make it more big. As you can see, it's starting. The features of the rtlsdr.dll panorama, it's the ability to save load scanning presents and it's allowed to run multiple copies to serve some dungeons at a time, and auto save settings into local folder and custom waterfall and spectrum graph color, and you can draw spectrum and draw time marks, and you can draw waterfall and the frequency monitor with the list of found frequencies, and you can save the waterfalls and spectrum images, and you can zoom spectrum in out using mouse. Okay, so let's check what's here. This is here AGC. You can use the AGC here, as you can see, and you can make auto DB. Let's make auto. Automatically adjust the DB axis, and you can put the maximum and the appearing here in the spectrum, as you can see from here, from the settings here. You can here use RTL power options to crop a presence by like 40%. As you can see, let's make it 0. You can enable peak hold, and you can disable peak hold, and you can direct sampling, and you can set color from spectrum graph color and spectrum maximum color, and the waterfall color from here. You can customize your color. Okay, and from a visual settings, you can show the devil axis as a dB and show frequency axis as a hertz, and you can limit the waterfall to the screen size. You can use it. You can draw time marks here. It will appearing when the spectrum is going down, and you can mark peaks from here. Okay. You can show high frequency monitor from here. As you can see here, this is a frequency monitor. You can show it from here. As you can see, you can take a picture from here. Immediately save the spectrum and waterfall bitmap file. Okay. As you can see. Okay, now let's stop. Let's see where's the CSV files. As we mentioned in the first of the video, the CSV files can be and then be used for analysis or the create a large frequency plot images. Okay, now let's going to see. As you can see here, here the picture. The pictures we make. Okay. Let's see the pictures when here the you as you can see the CSV file for the scan we make. Okay, as you can see from here the CSV file for as you can see here the frequency and all you can analyze the frequencies here and the gain, and you can manage, you can see where's the, if there's a jamming here or nothing. As you can see here the CSV file for scan. Okay, it's a useful tool. As you can see here the picture we created it from the software, and here the picture of the waterfall. So if I let the program for 2 or 3 minutes, I get a wide waterfall with analysis CSV file. So it's a useful tool using under Windows 10. It's based on RTL Power graphical user interface. As you can see from here. Okay, everyone, this is Canfor here. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned for another demonstration video. And 73, bye bye.